Welcome back to Shop Talk. We're talking about digital marketing strategies. And with us now is Brad Geiser, Managing Director of Geiser Maclang Marketing Communications. Hey, Brad, good to have you back on the show.
Hi, thanks for having me.
All right, we're talking about social media in business and how effective or non-effective it can be in the use of business. So our guests earlier had a photo booth, which you see often at parties now, but their photo booth is slightly different. Instead of sitting and waiting for your printout after your picture has been taken, there's an option to send it directly to your social media sites, to Twitter or Facebook or your email. And they found that this is really, really effective in for events, not personal events like weddings and birthdays, but more for product event launches and the like. Okay.
Yeah, actually one of our clients, Jamba Juice, has one of those things built permanently into their store. It's a big old touchscreen that allows you to take pictures, which is great because, you know, a lot of celebrities like to go into Jamba Juice and they like to be seen with.
and they send that to their social media sites or their emails.
Exactly so. Okay. You're going to see that particular technology start to be employed in a lot of different businesses over time. Because what a lot of people forget about social media is just a shadow on the wall. It's about what happens in real life that makes social media interesting. And companies sometimes forget that, you know. So in this case, companies like Jamba Juice that are very forward-thinking, actually Jamba Juice Philippines, which is run by the Maxis Group, very forward-thinking, said, let's make their experience at Jamba Juice something that's worthy of posting and give them the ability to post, and they did it, and they've been having a lot of fun with it ever since.
So this is that whole picture-taking thing, that's only in Jamba Juice Philippines? It's not in other Jamba Juices?
That's their innovation.
Fantastic.
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
There are a lot of clever people here.
Very, very innovative indeed, and I have to say that works with my kids. We go to Jamba, and that, you know, they order and then they run to the picture taking.
Isn't it great?
Yeah, amazing. Okay, so it's important to have an online presence. Mm-hmm. You know, have your Facebook page, your product page, but that doesn't mean, as you said, that anything's going to happen. I can have like a million likes on my page, but it doesn't mean that anybody's going to like my product or buy it.
Well, that's true.
I mean, no, maybe they like it, but that doesn't mean they'll buy it.
The most important thing that I can emphasize about social media is the idea of clarity of what it's for. Because a lot of people, they come in and they operate on what I would call faith or mysticism. Like, if I build it, they will come.
Yeah.
And do what? You know, in the case of having a million likes on Facebook, the concept that you could use for that are twofold. One is social proof. Social proof is the idea where somebody sees that your site has 2 million and goes, wow, that brand is really popular. Maybe I should try it. So that works that way. The other one is as a retention between ad spends. So if, let's say you're doing a marketing campaign and it starts from zero and it pops up and then it goes back down to zero, right? Well, if you can capture a large percentage of the audience, you can maybe keep them entertained for a couple of months more until you do your next campaign, in which they build off of each other instead of starting again from zero. So as you can see, having a million likes is useful if you know what to do with it. On the other hand, if I'll go back to that other example, Jamba Juice. Jamba Juice, when we created it and we first launched it out, it got basically 3 weeks, it got 14,000 fans with no promotions, no advertising, nothing. Now the beautiful thing about those fans is if you look at them, they are rabidly Jamba Juice. It's not casual Jamba Juice, and these people are brand ambassadors and they are drivers of sales for us. So sometimes it's better to have a million likes. Sometimes it's better to just have a few thousand likes of people who really like you. So it's a different animal.
Okay. All right. So what are the things that it takes, the factors that you need to know to make sure that your social media presence is working for you?
Well, there are lots and lots of different metrics. The internet changes really fast and there are new tools that are coming up all the time. But one of the most important tools that's available inside of the market now is something called social listening. And social listening is just like Google for social networking sites. It allows you to check certain search terms to see what people are actually doing and talking about. Companies that listen tend to do better than companies that don't listen, because companies that listen know what's actually relevant
and people are saying.
Exactly so. The other part of it is the other metric that is really neglected is organizations, while they may invest in the system, they don't invest in the content. Content is what makes things fascinating, right? Do you have marketing people that are students of the fascinating? Because if it's not interesting, nobody has to pay attention. That's the fundamental thing. Like in a case of a television commercial, producing television commercials is expensive, elaborate, and complicated, and therefore very few people actually do it. So even if you do a mediocre television commercial, chances are you'll do pretty well. Facebook, zero barrier to entry. Millions and millions of people actually doing it, which means that if you're not exquisite, you don't matter.
Right, okay. It's sort of like walking in the middle of the street, and if you're not wearing anything exceptional,
yeah,
nobody's really going to care.
Exactly so.
Right. Okay. Aside from those tips, how else can we use social media? I mean, an ordinary person, on this show we talk a lot to small and medium enterprises, and that's usually their entry point.
Mm-hmm.
How do they stand out?
Okay. Well, the first thing is know what you want to do and have a very simple goal. If you're trying to build a reputation, that's one particular strategy. If you're trying to drive sales, that's a different strategy. You can say, it's easy to say, I want it all. But having it all is really complicated. The second part is that they have to adopt what's called a laboratory mentality, which means that they need to have a commitment to making it work, trying, failing, because they're not experts who have seen 1,000 different models, who keep up on all the latest trends. That's why people suffer, people like me. the other part of it that's going to be very, very important is they need to do things that are social. Social media is called social media for a reason. It's not called commercial media. You can have social conversations about a brand or a product, you know, like for example, oh my God, one of our clients just launched recently, Geisha. Geisha, they let us try glow-in-the-dark salmon sashimi, and it was so cool.
It's not radioactive sashimi.
No,
right?
No, it's actually the bowl. It's you got to see it. It's great. It's fantastic. But the point is that it was so cool. I took the bowl. I whipped open my laptop. I took a self photo of myself, yeah, and I posted it on the Facebook, and it's like the glow of Geisha. And I had a whole bunch of people going like. But see, that's the point. It's being able to know what's fun and interesting and engaging and social. If I had turned around and I had said glow in the dark sashimi, 500 pesos at Geisha, that's a commercial conversation, not a social conversation.
And it wouldn't have nearly the same impact as your picture.
Human beings are weird that way. We don't like to mix our commercial with our social. We like our social to be social and our commercial to be commercial. And opinions take place socially, not commercially.
Okay, and that's what makes social media so important.
Exactly.
And so powerful if you use it correctly.
That's right.
Okay, now going back to what you were talking about earlier, the social listening.
Mm-hmm.
How does one do that? Is there like a special kind of software? Because as you said, if you Google something, it'll Google articles and websites.
Right.
I mean, the Google search will turn that up, but it won't turn up social media stuff so much.
Yeah, your viewers who are interested in looking this up should just go on Google and look up social media monitoring. Okay.
Okay.
Just search the term social media monitoring. You'll see dozens of different types of software ranging from free to insanely expensive for monitoring sentiment. Obviously, the more you pay, the more you get, and you can't really avoid that inevitability, but the free stuff keeps getting better and better.
And more things these days are just becoming free because the market's so competitive.
Exactly so, because everything evolves so bloody fast.
Right.
But it's more important to have the discipline inside of you, the willingness to shut up and listen, the willingness to go, what does this mean? Because a lot of entrepreneurs are very, they're fast. They're very instinctive, back of the brain kind of people. They're going, I want to go there, A, Z, you know. And they don't necessarily focus on the details. And that can be a problem because they get very frustrated very easily and they quit before they should. And social media requires a certain amount of persistence. That's the number one value for succeeding in social media.
Okay, so be realistic. Don't think you're going to become an instant hit overnight necessarily.
Well, actually, the worst part is when you become an instant hit overnight, because what happens is the second time you try it, you assume it's going to work, and it tanks, and you go, I must have lost it, or
what
something
did I
like
do?
That. Exactly. And that's why you need to be able to listen, because you need to be able to understand why you succeeded in the first place and understand that you'll never be able to succeed that way again. Probably you'll have to succeed a different way.
Right. So what other services do you think are out there or will eventually develop that will use digital marketing in this way, aside from the photo booth that I mentioned?
Oh, my goodness. There are services that are coming out all the time. There are direct marketing services, there are web app services, there are all these different tools. The main problem is knowing when and how to use them. For example, if Jamba Juice